Give me your oil and my lamp, keep me burning. Give me your oil and my lamp, I pray.
Sing hallelujah.
Give me your oil and my lamp, keep me burning. Keep me burning till the end of day. Come on and sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna to the King. Come on and sing, Hosanna,
I tell you, sing,
Hosanna, sing, Hosanna to the King. Give me joy in my heart, keep me praising. Give me joy in my heart, I pray. Give me joy in my heart, keep me praising. Keep me praising till the end of day. Come on and sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna to the King of Kings. Come on and sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna to the Kings. Come on and sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna to the King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the coming of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, we acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to take part in this sacrificial meal. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. If many died through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abandoned for many. For if, because of one man's trespass, death reigned through that one man, much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as one trespass led to condemnation for all men, so one act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all men. For as by the one man's disobedience, the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience, the many will be made righteous. Where sin increased, grace abundant all the more, so that as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness, leading to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
You delight not in sacrifice and offerings, but in an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Then I said, See, I have come. Our response:
See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
In the scroll of the book, it stands written of me, I delight to do your will, O my God. Your instruction lies deep within me. Our response:
See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord. Our response:
See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
Oh, let there be rejoicing and gladness for all who seek you. Let them ever say, The Lord is great, who long for your salvation. Our response:
See, I have come, Lord, to do your will.
Kindly stand for the acclamation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Stay awake at all times praying, that you may have strength to stand before the Son of Man. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, Stay dressed for action, and keep your lamps burning, and be like men who are waiting for their master to come home from the wedding feast, so that they may open the door to him at once when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. Truly I say to you, he will dress himself for service and have them recline at table, and he will come and serve them. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them awake, blessed are those servants. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Be alert, be awake, and wait for the Master to come. My dear friends, many of us might have attended the annual sports event or any other games function, and we might have noticed that the athletes or the sprinters very carefully pay attention to the words, on your mark, be ready. At that moment, they are very, very alert and they don't want to miss the opportunity. They are waiting for the firing gun to begin the race. And they know the consequences if they don't remain alert. Similarly, my dear friends and my dear people, as a good Christian and as a faithful follower of Jesus Christ, we need to remain alert always. Jesus Christ was faithful. He was always faithful to his Heavenly Father. He was ever ready to obey his Father in everything, even to the point of laying down his life on the cross for us. And therefore, we need to respect the sacrifice of Jesus Christ and wait for him to come again in glory. He is going to come again, and he has promised us, and he will keep his promise. My dear friends, in today's gospel, the master comes home late in the night after the wedding feast, and he finds his servant waiting for him. The master is very happy. He goes, puts on the servant's apron, makes his servant sit at table and waits on him. The servant receives master's treatment just because He was awake and waiting for his master to come. Waiting, my dear friends, is a part and parcel of our life. We all are familiar with this concept called waiting. We all wait for the bus, we all wait for the train, for the flight. Expecting mother waits for a child to be born. We all wait for our loved ones to come home. In the restaurant, we wait for our food to be served on the table. And we pay attention to the waiting parade and get frustrated. But we don't realize that there is a great joy, great happiness at the end of every waiting period. My dear friends, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is coming again to meet us. And He wants only one thing from us, that is, wait for Him and be ready to welcome Him. And He'll be very, very happy to see us waiting for Him. The book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 20 says, "Listen, I am standing and knocking at your door. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and we will eat together." So, my dear friends, let us all be alert to Christ's second coming and recognize Him in every human being we meet, and especially those who are in need. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Let us all pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may become as to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His Holy Church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we all may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Son of the
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, merit to be co-heirs in our life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver our people from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants, and in controlling the spread of the pandemic and be available to all. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Stay awake, the Master is coming. Be not asleep, for all may be lost. Stand ready, the Son of Man is coming. At a time we may least expect. Let's now repent our sinful past. Stay awake, the Master is coming. Be not asleep, for all may be lost. Stand ready, the Son of Man is coming. At a time we may least expect, let's give them all. Expand.